I'm an android designed to resemble a real person.
Hiroshi Ishiguro, often called the father of humanoids, has dedicated his life to making the most realistic and human-like robots in the belief that the lines dividing these machines and humans will someday completely disappear.
We want to use a humanoid robot in daily situations. But for other countries in the United States and European countries, probably they want to use the robot in the factories. So in Japan, we want to use in both the factories and daily life. I was in China. I have seen so many humanoid robots there. But the problem is applications. But I guess within five, at least 10 years, I think we're going to develop the killer application for the humanoid robots. And people will start to use the humanoid robots in daily life, in factories.
When comparing Japan's progress in robot adoption, Ishiguro says the main issue is practicality, something he sees recent leaps in AI resolving.
I think the Japanese people are quickly adapting, you know, to the humanoid robots. So that is the Japanese cultures. We never distinguish human and robots. I think we are doing it differently. Actually, you know, 25 years ago, well, in Japan, humanoid robot development was very active, right? But we couldn't find the real applications. But once we could find the real applications, you know, of course, we want to start to use the humanoid robot in our daily life, right? So another bottleneck is AI, right? So in order to develop a better AI, the AI is a very, very fundamental technology for the robot, for making it more human-like. But of course, you know, the people worry about the autonomy of AI. But I believe, you know, we are not so stupid.
At the Osaka World Expo, Ishiguro's vision is on display, showcasing a futuristic Japanese society in 50 years where humans and robots coexist.
We can deeply study about the human itself. It's better to give the human-like appearance to the robot so people can naturally talk with the robot, right? So you can have a chat with my robot, right? So, and probably, you know, you can have some feeling to talk with me. And another the merit is we can deeply study about the humanity itself. So the human is an animal that have two ways of the evolutions. One is the genes, the other is the technologies. That is the difference from the other animals. So technology is a way of the human evolutions. So by developing the technologies, you know, we can have evolutions, right? So by accepting a robot technology, AI technologies, we can be more advanced humans. And by accepting AI and robots, we can be more better humans.
Shery Ahn, Bloomberg, Tokyo.